Hello everyone, and welcome to the CSS Security Mini Briefing, where we will present a short summary of what was released today, April 13th, 2021. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a Security Program Manager in the Customer Service and Support Organization here at Microsoft. We're going to start this video with an overview of the release and then dive into a few vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities we are covering may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content and the security update guide. All right, so we'll start with an overview of the release. And for this month, we have 108 total vulnerabilities that are being addressed, which is just slightly above our 13-month running average of 104. When we dive in a little bit deeper, we see 19 total critical vulnerabilities, a little bit above our average. When we look at the remote code execution vulnerabilities this month, we'll see an anomaly. We'll see 56 total vulnerabilities, which is almost double our average of 32 per month. As we look at the CVSS scoring of the vulnerabilities, the highest rated this month is 9.8 out of a scale of 10. And when we look at the average of the score across the entire release, we see 7.51, which is just above our average of 7.24. As we look towards the publicly disclosed vulnerabilities, this month we have 4 vulnerabilities being addressed. And then moving over to exploited, known to be exploited vulnerabilities, this month we have 1. We'll talk about that in just a moment. So as we look at the release all up, we see a lot of remote code execution vulnerabilities and high severity vulnerabilities as well. So, you know, I say this kind of every month, but this is definitely not a month to delay or skip patching because there are definitely some critical items in here. And so let's dive right into our first one. All right, so the first vulnerability that we will cover this month, this is CVE-2021-28310. This is a Win32k elevation of privilege vulnerability listed as important and known to be exploited out in the wild. The base score on this is 7.8 out of a scale of 10. And so while it's not extraordinarily high, it is still, like I said, known to be exploited out in the wild. We don't have any IOCs to share with this because we haven't seen any evidence of exploitation in our own telemetry. So we don't really have those kind of things available. However, the key here is install the update and you will be protected. There's no extra steps that has to be taken here. So in regards to this one, update Windows and you are protected. So let's move on to our second vulnerability. This is CVE-2021-28329. And this is a remote procedure call runtime remote code execution vulnerability. There's actually 27 very similar vulnerabilities this month with all the exact same headline here, rated at 8.8 on a scale of 10. And so we'll cover this one vulnerability because it's indicative of a set of very similar vulnerabilities. So what we have here is the attack vector is over the network, low complexity, low privileges required, but no user interaction is required. So that's kind of key. And one of the reasons why this is an 8.8 on a scale of 10. So there's not a whole lot to talk about here, but you can protect yourself simply by installing Windows updates. And you don't have to worry about any extra steps that go into this. There's no workarounds, no mitigation. The key here is install the patch as soon as you can, and you will be protected from this vulnerability. So the third vulnerability that we'll cover today, this is CVE-2021-28480. And this is a vulnerability with Exchange. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability scored at 9.8 on a scale of 10. So this is incredibly critical that if you have Exchange in your environment, please prioritize patching. So this is not related to any of the vulnerabilities that were released out of band with Exchange last month. These are completely different, completely separate. These are not known to be exploited out in the wild at the time of release, but threat actors are looking very carefully at any changes Microsoft makes and trying to build their own attack mechanisms to leverage these new vulnerabilities. So again, please prioritize updating if you can. So last month we ended up releasing security updates for a lot of versions of Exchange that are out of support. We have no plans to release any out of support updates for Exchange this month. So in order to install the security update, you have to be on a supported version of Exchange. That's the latest two cumulative updates for Exchange 2019 and 2016, and the latest one cumulative update in Exchange 2013. No updates for Exchange 2010 this month. There are no available ones because Exchange 2010 is out of support. So again, if you have an out of support version of Exchange, you first have to upgrade your environment, get on a supported version of Exchange, and then install the April security updates for Exchange. So there's actually four vulnerabilities with Exchange this month. Two are rated at 9.8, one's rated at 9, one's rated at 8.8. So very similar here in some of the public information here, but it's real key that at least with this one, 28480, excuse me, this one requires no privileges and no user interaction. And it's a 9.8 on a scale of 10. This should encourage you to update as soon as possible so you can protect yourself from these vulnerabilities. There are no workarounds, no mitigations known for this. You need to install the updates and then you'll be protected. All right, and with that brings us to a close for today's mini briefing. And I thank you for your time and encourage you to come back next month and we'll talk about vulnerabilities in May. Thank you very much.